year, about 565,000 Americans are expected to die of cancer.
That's more than 1,500 people every day.
Patients' number one fear is not dying from cancer, but being defined by their illness.
Francis, a depressed teenager struggling with cancer, takes us through his journey when he moves into a specialist unit to receive treatment, and with his fellow patient Amber, how he chooses to define himself with the help of
The Brilliant Light of Amber Sunrise
by Matthew Crowe. Do you want to watch an old film? We haven't got any DVDs at the minute, though. You've got to use the menu. Select one from there.
I'm on it. I just can't stand the crap that seems to be coming out of everyone's mouth. It's not her fault. She's doing the best she can with grim genetics. Ugh, Titanic. Kill me now.
It's probably the greatest romance of our time. Their love was as doomed as that voyage.
Yeah, that film's the worst. You're killing me, Frankie.
So why do you only watch old films anyway? I mean, I like them. Now you've told me to. But who made you like them?
No one made me like them. I just do. My daddy's put them on for us to watch after Sunday lunch. Hey, you okay today? You keep grimacing.
I'm sorry.
You don't have to apologize, Frankie. I'm just chatting.
I know, but it's what you're supposed to say, isn't it? But I'm fine.
Good. Things are a lot more interesting with you around. I'm just saying, I know what it's like when people die. I know that it's just one less person at the dinner table, and they don't take the whole world with them. It carries on like it always has, only a bit sadder. For a bit, so that's why I'm not scared. Try bringing in some conversation, Frankie.
I know what it's like too, when people die.
Your dad died too?
No, he's just not around.
Sorry.
You don't have to apologize.
Just what people say, isn't it?
Excuse me. Amber, as the man in our... It's my responsibility to... Just to make things clear, there's no pressure, but... Are you my girlfriend?
Don't get ahead of yourself, Francis. Francis! Francis, are you awake? I'm gonna need you to work this for me.
Have you been stealing?
Come on.
But a joint toilet trip at this hour might incur all sorts of suspicion and reprisals. We're better to just do as told and wait until morning to carry out any schemes or shenanigans. The rules are there for our benefit.
Oh, Francis, we all need our heroes. I just wish you hadn't chosen John Lithgow from Footloose.
Had you really watched Footloose all the way through, you would have seen John Lithgow comes good in the end. So the joke is really on you.
I want you to scout me, so I'm one step ahead of the game.
But it might not even come out. It doesn't all the time. It says so in the leaflet.
Not a risk I'm willing to take. Here, scout me.
Bzzz. Someone's gonna hear. We'll get in trouble.
No, we won't. If anyone comes, you just start crying and tell them that you've got cancer. No one's gonna press the subject after that. Now it's your turn.
I think it'll give me a bit of an edge, to be honest.
Seen yourself yet? Come on. Well, at least we don't have to worry about us attracting anyone.
There's that.
Cancer. One-way ticket to monogamy. They never put that in the leaflets.
They should. It's always the negatives they seem to dwell on. I think we're due a bit of good publicity.
Right. You're an odd-looking thing. We should get back before we get caught. I wouldn't want anyone to think I'm leading you astray.
Amber? Amber. Amber! At first, the nurse said that the medicine was taking. Then I was responding well, which meant that I wasn't throwing up. Basically, I've been going about my daily business without needing to take a nap to recover from my previous nap or throwing up. But Amber seems to be going the opposite direction. Do you know how many answers the magic 8-ball beside your bed holds? It's 21. 10 positive, 6 negative, and 5 medium.
Just leave it, Francis.
I don't see what the problem is. Is this about your face? I just didn't think you cared about that sort of thing. Everyone reacts to chemo differently. I still think you're pretty.
What's your problem anyway? I'm sure if you tried hard enough, someone would be willing to overlook you being such a total creep. Do you really think I'd have given you the time of day if I wasn't bald and ugly and rotten to the core? Will Amber and Francis's glorious love story resume? It's decidedly so. Well, I knew there was something to all this fake business. Tough crowd.
Will Amber ever apologize for being a total cow?
Stars say, nah. Suppose you can't win them all. Will we ever get out of this ward alive?
Don't.
Will Amber and Francis be immortalized in death like Romeo and Juliet?
Don't!
Will Amber ever decide to give it a rest and let Francis have an easy life?
Concentrate and ask.
If I promise to concentrate really hard in the future, Francis, will you be my friend again?
All right. But I never said that I wanted an easy life. After a few weeks, I was getting better, but Amber wasn't. The truth was, she was getting worse, and she knew it. Worst of all, as upsetting as the thought of her being ill was for me, all I could really think about was where this would leave us, especially since they told me I could go home. Mom helped me make a pewter magic 8-ball necklace.
Is this a thing now?
Yeah, I told you about it, remember? It is a thing. It can be our thing. It's only got one response written on the bottom. Yes, so it always gives a good answer.
What if I ask it a bad question, though?
I didn't think that bit through. But it would be a big help if you didn't, okay?
Love it. I didn't get you anything though. My presence is a present, I suppose.
I have to go. But text me whenever you can, alright?
I need to do this on my own, Francis. I need you to understand that.
I don't. We're a team.
I know, and we are, but this is something I need you to do for me. I need you not to text me, I need you not to visit, and I need you to let me be. Everything's still the same between us. Nothing's changed, but this is something I have to do for myself.
Amber? Amber, I know you're tired and that you're unwell, but I need you to get better because I'm getting better. I know you're scared, but I'm scared about having to do anything or to go anywhere.
I want my hair back. I don't want to go anywhere without my hair.
Amber, please, just get up.
Everything is going to be okay.
Amber? Amber? Amber! Is everything going to be okay?